Boxing King Media in association with Boxtro. Pat Barrett out here in Liverpool. Pat, I asked you a bit ago, has anyone in particular come to watch tonight?
No, not really, no. Just, you know, mate, just down with the boxers. I'm here with CJ Challenger, Niall Brown. That's why we come down.
You just seen Josh Kelly's performance. How did you rate it? Obviously, it's been over a year since he fought.
He boxed well. He did what he had to do. He got him out of there. Put some good variety of punches together. He's a good prospect.
Very, very good. And I think at super welterweight, what do you think his chances are at super welterweight now that he's moved up?
Well, we just have to wait and see, innit? I can't really say what his chances are. You know what I mean? So it's not really. It's unquestionable for what I've got to say. What his chances are, I just have to see.
Gonna get stuff out of you, Pat. Nathan Gorman, main event. What are you expecting to see from, you know, fighting his Czech champion?
Again, Nathan Gorman was one of the hottest prospects, along with Dubois. He's been off for a little bit. He's back and forth. But if he can get the way he can be, Nathan Gorman's very good.
Good stuff. The main reason I've dragged you back here is I want to speak to you about Amaar Akbar. You've been working with him for, 8-9 months now?
Yeah.
And I believe his last performance, he really showed the work that you guys have been putting into the gym together. So I'm guessing you've watched it back. You know, talk to me about the performance.
You know what? I thought Amaar boxed really well. There's little bits in it where, I can be critical about it. But overall, considering we just started working together, first fight me being in his corner with him, I thought, good 3 out of 4 rounds, he boxed brilliant, switched up a little bit, but again, that's just nothing that we can't put right when we go back in the training. And I thought, this kid for me is one, if I'm going to tip him to say, he's going to go all the way. I like his style, I like his attitude, I like his mentality, I like how he changes up, I like how he listens, I like how he thinks. There's a lot of good things about him that I like, so yeah.
There was resemblances of, Zelfa Barrett's performance, that almost that rhythm of, just kind of making the opponent think that you're going to do something, but you don't, and then you're bringing different shots in. Would I be right in saying that?
Well, let's just say the club has a trademark, and if you notice, the Kronk Detroit, most of the fighters had a good left jab. It was very accurate. They started off, they put you on the back foot, they know how to control the centre of the ring, and they also know how to box. And I suppose my trade thing is a jab, is defence, is not getting hit, is working behind a good jab, good defence, and good footwork, mobility if you need it. So yeah, there's always going to be certain similarities, but take in mind, they're all different fighters, each and every one of them are all individuals.
And obviously the size, he looked like he put a bit of size on as well from his last performance. Is that going to help him in the long run?
When you say size, he's big for the weight anyway. I mean, when I say he's big for the weight, he's a tall kid. He's 5'11" for a light welterweight. I mean, he's obviously boxing the same weight as I was at, and I was big at the time, but he's also bigger than me. So, it's not like putting size on it, he's just natural.
Sound. And a quick word on Zelfa. Amazing performance last time out. Everyone wants to see him in a world title fight. Have you been throwing any names in your direction as to who you could potentially target?
Why would we throw names at a world title fight? He's just one of the European. I mean, let's talk about what he is, not where he's going to go. I mean, he's going to get that world title shot eventually. But, what he's just done is spectacular. He's just won the European title. Now, let's look for a European title defence. And then, obviously, options and options from there on, really.
Good stuff, man. I've got to get your opinion on Julius Francis. Have you seen the video?
I've got nothing to say. I mean, Julius Francis what can you say? Push comes to shove. It's what you do, innit? You know what I mean? You can't tell a man not to do anything when you got a crazy man running around like he's going to blam everybody. So he did what he had to do and, put him to sleep. So good on him.
Brilliant right hand. Reminded me of some of your right hands from back in the day.
I don't know. I think my right hands are a bit rusty at the moment. I've never had the chance to be like Julius Francis like this. But we'll find out one day.
Good man, Pat. Anything else you want to add before I let you go?
No. Just that one thing I'd like to say is apologise to everybody that was supporting us for the June 18 show and having to pull it due to circumstances, fights not being off, fighters coming off the show. It was a 12-card show, dropped down to 8. And it was a big venue, very expensive, and the fights that we Addo unfortunately couldn't cover the cost of the show, so rather than losing a lot of money on the show, we just leave it, go 6 weeks later in Oldham.
Oldham, just to confirm, that's July the 30th, a big show, a big Black Bash promotion show. What's going to be the main couple of fights on there?
Well, CJ Challenger's doing an 8-rounder, topping the bill, and all the lads that didn't make that show will be on it, and plus a couple of new addition fighters that I've got. Little Darbo is making his debut, and a couple of other lads making a debut on that show. So, yeah, it'll be a spectacular show.
Good stuff, Pat. Thank you for your time, and speak to you soon.
Thank you.